Welcome back. It is the third segment on Off the Pitch. My name is Desire. Derek Ford Mogumisa. Kevin Awino, he's still here with us. And yeah, she's the Cricket Cranes, Lady Cricket Cranes captain. And just inquisitively asking, are you now used to the title? Like when they mention she's the captain of the Lady Cricket Cranes, do you still feel some butterflies? Do you still need some time to believe I am the captain of this national team?
No.
You are used to it now?
Yes, I'm used.
The first time I played for my school team, I used to play rugby. And that is the highest level of rugby I ever played, school team. I got onto the pitch and I had, I think that's what they call butterflies. I was very nervous as well. And what I was imagining is all those kids we left at school, all those buildings at school. I was picturing all of this. I am representing that. And somehow I succumbed under the pressure a couple of times. And I would imagine it would be much, much worse if I was the national team captain. How much? How come you are not nervous? How come you still cannot believe it?
At first, I was so nervous.
Yeah.
I got scared because I even reached a point of telling some of my teammates, how will I manage to captain this team? There are some big women.
Yeah.
The senior players.
Yeah. Older than you.
Yes. I'm young. How
and
will I?
And you're coming in as the captain.
Yes.
You are what, 16? I think.
21.
You are 21 then?
Yes.
Okay, yeah. Uh-huh.
So, actually, this year is my first year to be.
To be the captain.
Okay, it was last year.
Yeah, it was year. Last year. 2017.
Yes.
Yeah.
So this year, let me say it's the second one.
Yeah. If time flies, doesn't it? Okay, so you're telling us about how you were looking at all these senior players. Yeah.
So I got scared. But even them, they came to me. They told me, feel free, talk to us. We will help you. We know you are young, but we're going to help you. Indeed, they helped me. That's why now I'm not nervous.
Okay.
I'm strong. I believe I'm the captain of Uganda.
21, captain of the national team, with the senior players and all. Doesn't that put you in a specific position where you have to make, say, tough decisions, for example, for the team? And of course, a couple of players are going to be hurt in a way by those decisions. And sometimes they are older than you. How do you get to deal with that?
As a captain, you have to be mentally tough.
Yeah.
Yes. If you don't be mentally tough, you will not manage the team.
Yeah.
Yes.
And you've never felt intimidated by the fact that you are younger than the people you are leading?
No.
You are such a strong lady, aren't you? Now, speaking of strength, if you're already strong, but if we said we gave you superpowers, you've watched superpowers. You've watched movies with superpowers, right? Which ones would you prefer? The ones whereby you are the good person, or the ones whereby you are the villain?
I would need all.
You need both?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to let you tell us why you need both, but later you'll have to choose one. We cannot
be
giving
you both. Let me just choose one.
Okay, all right.
Okay, the good one.
The good one. That's the easy one.
The good one.
And what would that power be? If you had to choose it,
I would like to be someone who is approachable, a good captain, a good person.
No, we're talking about the superpowers. We are away from the reality.
The superpowers.
Yes, fantasy. If that was, there could be a power to what? For the good powers. I mean, I can save people. I can fly. I can stay in water for a long time.
Me, the only thing I can say is that that power, that potential to take Uganda to the World Cup.
Okay.
As me, what, the captain.
Whichever it may be, for as long as I can take Uganda to the World Cup, that is a superpower
Yes.
enough. Okay. I'm going to ask you another power-related question or, well, fantasy-related question. If you were able to read or to know what will happen in the next 24 hours, I am able to tell that by this time tomorrow, I will have done this, I will have done that, I would have done this. Would you take it?
I would take it, but to be sincere, no one can.
Yeah, no one can do that. We are now just imagining. We are just imagining. Would you take it? Would you want that? Or do you love the surprises that life comes with?
Anyway, I would love the surprises. Yeah.
Okay, so you wouldn't take it?
Yes.
On second thought? Mm. Okay, again, still with the powers. The final one. The final question. Final question. If you were able to control, to read what people are thinking, yeah, and that is for the rest of your life. If you are able to read what people are thinking about you, about the world, about anything, would you love that power?
I don't love that.
You don't love that?
Yes.
You don't want to be able to think, to know what I'm thinking about you?
No, I don't want.
Why?
At a certain point, it isn't easy. Yeah. You may hate someone because of what is he or she is thinking about you.
Mm-hmm.
So you rather let it go and move on.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Very interesting perspective about life there. Another what if. No, it's not powers. What if. What if you didn't know how old you are? You went to bed tonight, you woke up in the morning, you don't know, you wake up and you don't know how old you are.
Mm.
And you have to choose an age, a random age. Mm. Which age would you choose?
Me?
Yeah.
That's a hard question. I can't answer that.
They're not meant to be easy.
I can't answer that.
No, just a random answer. If I woke up today, personally, I think I would wake up at the age of, I'm 28 now, so I would wake up at the age of 22, because then I think I'm done with school, I have an idea what the work sphere is like, and maybe I would make better decisions, or maybe different decisions.
For that, I can't answer it.
You still can't answer it, even with the example. Okay, all right, let's get to move on. If you knew you would die at 40, you are 21 today, right? If you knew you would die at 40, what are you doing with your life today, knowing that life is much shorter? What would you be doing differently with your life?
I would make my life happy.
Happy?
Yeah.
You don't think you have strived to be happy enough? You would try and be happier?
Yes.
Okay. What do you feel? You are maybe cricket, because of course cricket is quite the schedule right now. You have to travel, you have to be in different places. Mm. What are some of those things you feel cricket robs you of?
They're not like
huge.
Yes.
But what are those little things you think cricket robs you of? Clearly you are happy to lose them now because cricket is bigger for you. Mm-hmm. But what are those that you feel it's not giving you time enough to do?
Actually, let me say, for now,
there are tiny things.
Yes.
Things that you won't even probably mention.
Yes.
Okay. All right. We'll leave that one at that. What was the last thing you got that was totally free of charge?
Free of charge?
Yeah. It was free. You got it. You loved it. But it was free. That was the biggest thing about it.
Let me see. A cake.
A cake?
Yeah.
How big was it?
It was big, but it was for my mom.
Ah.
Yeah.
Birthday?
Birthday cake.
A birthday cake.
Yes.
Do you celebrate your birthdays?
Yes.
Every single year?
Yes.
And what do you usually do?
I celebrate it with my team.
Oh. Okay.
Yes. Normally it happens when we are going to Kwibuka Rwanda tournament, Kwibuka
yeah.
tournament.
Yeah.
But now I'm no longer in school cricket tournament. So I'll be celebrating it with my teammates, national team.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. And the team is definitely something that is a very big part of you. I can tell from the conversations that we've gotten to have here. So I will want to ask, I'm inquisitive on this. What is that one thing you want Kevin Awino to be remembered for? Like 20 years from today, you are no longer on the national team. You've served and well for the time you've managed to serve. What do you want that news guy to be saying about you as far as your legacy gets to go? What do you want to be remembered for?
I want to be remembered as the best wicket keeper, the first one, and then the best captain ever for Uganda. And I really need everyone to talk about me, that I was the captain who took Uganda for the World Cup.
That is really a huge dream for you, the captain that took Uganda to the World Cup.
Yes.
How realistic is this dream?
The way, like, I see it, because even it was our first year to qualify for World Cup qualifiers, and I'm the first captain who took Uganda
Who took us to the global qualifiers.
Yes.
And you feel it's very possible then?
Yes, it's possible.
All right. A short break we will take right away. When we get back, we finalize with the lady that is Kevin Awino. We are very, very grateful to be hanging out with cricket royalty, people.